Oh, shoot. Forgot that I will fall in there. Okay, come on. Oh my god, look at that armor. It's freaking awesome looking. Hey, welcome back guys, it's Slaughter Havoc here, and we are back on the Revenge of the Sea Team server, and today, with that stuff, well, you know, what do I gotta say? I've had a bad day of it. I was gonna do one episode, and actually I did record quite a bit of it, and then, you know, I went back and kind of listened to myself during the editing, and I didn't really enjoy listening to myself, listening to what was going on. It was kind of lagging. Or dragging, really, and I didn't have a lot of high energy, and, you know, I was like, you know what, I want to have fun when I'm doing this, and if I'm not having fun, then what's the point? And basically, it was just a little build episode. I've never really done a build episode, because, I mean, me personally, I don't know if anybody really wants to watch us build, or, you know, watch me build and stuff like that, and all I did was I kind of added this little, what I'm calling my ritual altar, to the overall blood magic altar here. And I don't know, I think it looks kind of cool. I put up my first ritual because I did want to bind a couple tools, which I did right here. And now I have a bound pickaxe as well as a bound shovel to go along with the bound sword that we already had. All right, but I digress. Anyways, moving on. I had it because I wanted to go do some mining. And, okay, I've done this thing like 100 times before. You see in my hand right now how it's a ball, and then I right click and it turns, or shift right click and it turns into a pickaxe, and I shift right click and it goes back into a ball, right? Well, when, I guess I can just give you an example how destructive this thing can be. When you right click on it, like right click now, it does nothing. But when you right click in it with it in your hand and it is active, and what I mean by active is, I mean, it is, you know what? I got night vision on, turn that off. When it's a pickaxe, and you right click, watch, let's just see what happens here. It takes a huge chunk of ground, and yeah, that's what it does. It basically mines everything within an 11 by 11 by 11 area. So needless to say, you can see how much damage this can be. If you have this in your hand and you forget to turn it off, there's a hole right here. Oh, is that another cave I did? No, it doesn't. Well, is it? Oh no, there's just like a cave right there. Cool. So you know, when I've got this in my hand and I accidentally do that because I forget to turn it off, like opening a door to my house, it can be very, very destructive, and it has been. I actually had it happen back to back within a matter of seconds. I was out at my blood altar, and I had a creeper that randomly blew up. It was outside the walls. It had nothing to do with me. But if you can see all this broken glass right here, yeah, there was a creeper that just blew up randomly. And I still yet to fix it because, well, it's not a big deal. I will get it fixed. So I'm going back over here, and I was like, you know, I'm going to go fix this real quick. I'm going to go grab some carpenter's blocks. And I had my axe in my hand and went to open the door and clicked here instead of on the door. And all of this got leveled. Everything that's not wood. These basalt pavers, all of this, floors down, all of this gone, wiped out. So I've spent the last, I don't know, hour or two cleaning up. But the reason I actually got the pickaxe, and I should have grabbed it while I was over here, is there is, well, I mean, the reason I got the pickaxe was because I needed materials. And then I also realized that I remember the sigil from before, and I believe I have it in the chest right now. Yes, I do. So check this bad boy out. This is called the Sigil of Compression, right? If you have anything that can be compressed, like I have 22 coal right here, right? If I turn this thing on, you'll hear him start clicking and stuff. It'll compress anything that can be compressed. So 22 coal can technically be turned into 2 coal blocks because there's 9 each, right? Which would be 18, and then I'd have 4 coal left over. But look at what else it does. So it didn't even do the coal. It did all this cobblestone. Now, I don't know why it didn't do the rest here. That's kind of interesting. I'm actually kind of curious as to why it didn't. But now I've got all this compressed cobblestone and these double compressed cobblestones. It should be doing these. I'm really not sure why it's not right now. like why it's stopping at that point. I don't think I'm using up all my essence. No, I thought I don't know. But anyways, I just thought that thing was kind of cool because if I'm down mining and stuff like that, I'll just throw it all in here for right now. That could be really, really useful for constantly compressing the coal or the cobblestone so it doesn't take up my entire inventory, right? But anyways, the whole point is today I want to get the armor done for blood magic because it's really, really cool and you can do some really cool mods with it. And I don't know, is that a robot? Did you drop another gun? That would be cool if you dropped another gun. I could give it, oh, you did. You did. Legendary Omnitool. This one's 1175, 13. Okay, the one I actually have is a little bit better. Speed 70, range 24 blocks, range 24 blocks. Yeah, so it's about the same, but the one I already have is a little bit better. But yay, another one of those Omnitools are cool. Oh, I got a chest plate. I didn't even realize that. That's for range android. Oh, I kind of need that one, actually. So anyways, I want to do the armor. But there's a few things I need to get for the armor first. And that is a couple modifications that we can do to it. So we're going to just, I've already done most of it because I knew I was going to do it off camera. Oh, you know, I forgot to grab those lights. Inverted, yeah, there they are. This also, like to show you the range of how much damage that thing did, it took down, it tore down my lights inside of here. Just, oh, just ridiculous. Just absolutely ridiculous. It was so upsetting. I just tore it all up. But anyways, we need to make a couple things because to upgrade armor, what you do is you actually throw in, I'll just throw all this in here for right now. You throw in a couple sigils and you can upgrade them with like the kind of traits that they have. Not exactly the same, but for the most part, like I have two of these divination sigils and this is what I'm going to use because when this is in my hand, you can kind of see my HUD pop up in the top left-hand corner right there. It's going away, then it's there. And that just tells me how much life essence is in my my system or whatever. But if it's in my armor, then it's automatically going to be there. Now, the other ones I want to do, where are the recipes for them? I believe Fast Miner is one of them. And that is with an iron pickaxe, iron, and iron shovel. So shovel, pickaxe. And so I'm going to need, what, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and 1. And then 1, 2, 1, 2, and 1, 2. Yeah, there we go. So I've got all those. Let me go ahead and grab just all the stone because I don't know how much stone I'm going to need. And I think I have a couple of these over there, these reinforced slates. But I'm going to want to do the fast miner because this will just give me haste all the time, like when I'm mining and stuff. Now the sigil of haste, that is with a demonic slate, 2 obsidian, 2 cookies, and sugar. I think I have cookies. I do. And I believe obsidian is right here. All right, and that was the recipe for that one. Obsidian, sugar, and then the slates are over there. Cool, so I've got that. And then the other one I wanted to do, oh yes. So it's actually, it's the green one. It's the sigil of the whirlwind, but I need to make the air sigil first. So air sigil, 6 feathers, a ghast tier, and the reinforced slate. And then the better one is that particular sigil with 4 more feathers. So 10 feathers, 3 tiers, and 2 of those slates. So I know I have umpteen feathers. I just need 10 of them. And then ghast tiers, I'm going to need, what, 3? Ooh, I got 4. Cool. And that was it, the slate, and then yeah, so that should be it. All right, so here's all the materials I need to make all these slates, minus oh shoot, okay, there's the pick, there's that, I got the stone. Okay, so that one's done and ready. And then haste. Cookies I got, sugar I got, obsidian I got. Okay, I'm just gonna make the slate for that one. And then air, I've got the feathers and the gap. Okay, cool, so we can make the rest of these out of there. I just need my sigils and my orbs and stuff. And we're gonna go make these guys. Because I can throw these into the individual armor pieces, and it gives us some fun traits. Like speed, and I can do jump. I believe the whirlwind one is the one I like because it any projectiles. So the skeletons, not that they can harm me, but they can annoy the crap out of me. And, oh, cool. I do have one of these. Do I have any of the higher level slates in here? No, I need to make some. Okay. Well, I can craft up the first one, which is this guy, right? So there we go. So it's shovel, pick, axe, this thing. And of course, I'm going to drop all that now because I don't have my orb on me. There we go. You know what? Just to make sure I have the high level one. Oh, you know what? And while this is going, I do have to fill one more of these sockets. And that tank is almost full. I need one more of these because I'm actually making all the armor stuff right now. And so what it is, you just put this in here. It slowly fills up. It takes like 30,000 life essence to fill one of these little sockets up. And I've got 27 of them in here. 24 for the armor and then 4 for one more block I have to make. So yeah. So anyway, so the haste guy, so it's shovel, pickaxe, axe, this reinforced slate, my orb, and some stone. Was that it? Yes. All right. And then I need to beefen these guys up. And in between this episode and next episode, I'm going to start changing out some of these runes. Now, as you can see, I've got different runes here that weren't here before, and these are augmenting capacity runes. And they're pretty easy to make. If I remember correctly, it was three buckets, four stones, one of these imbued slates, and that'll give you one of these stones. And no, you don't get the bucket back. Oh, thank you. And so I went through a lot of iron buckets to make the ones that I did have. There we go. Oh, and actually, I can craft up you real quick. 1, 2, 3, 4. I might just keep them all on me. And, okay, there we go. So what I need these for is because this is like the, kind of like the anvil of the blood magic thing here. Nope, not you. You, right? And it gives me the soul armor forge, right? And you'll see why this thing is so cool shortly. Because while this is filling up, actually, I think I should be able to get these cooked up, get you going. I'm going to go ahead and set up our armor forge. Oh, maybe I'll do it. I mean, I don't have to do anywhere special. It's not a really big build or anything like that. It's just a couple blocks. Here, we'll do it like this. Okay. So you take these sockets like this and say we're going to create a chest plate, right? So, oh, God, that's so annoying. So annoying. Give me all those blocks back. Oh, I'm not flying. Oopsie. Freaking carpenter's blocks. I always forget and I try to set stuff down on them and then it does that. So very annoying to forget about that. There we go. All right. So let's try that again. So I'm going to shift click, right? So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. See, like, that is the normal shape of a chest plate if it's in your crafting table, right? Well, then I just put the soul forge in here, and I give it a little right-click, and it would give me the armor piece. But we want to upgrade this bad boy. We want to add an upgrade to it. So, since I've already got the one of haste, I'm going to go grab a couple extra blood shards, because you need to add a blood shard to do an upgrade. Like so. I'm going to need one more blood shard. So, basically, all I do is I take this blood shard right here, and I right-click, and you see it took one, right? Bingo, bingo. Now, if I put the Sigil of Haste in there, oops, do I have to go to a different block? Oh, yeah, different block. And then I just right-click. Now I've got this armor right here, bound plate, right? This armor just looks so freaking cool. Look at the design of this armor. It is, okay, I got to take that gun out of that slot. It looks so cool, and all of it maintains that same kind of design. But now I have haste, and I believe if I go to E, you'll see I have permanent haste. So mining just got so much easier. Freaking awesome. All right, but I've got to go get the, oh, that other sigil should be done by now. Is it imbued yet? Nope, I gotta let the blood build up a little bit. So as that's collecting and leveling up, we can go and start the next shape. Oh, you know what? I already have an extra divination sigil, so we can do that one too. Where's my divination sigil? I have an extra one somewhere. Ah, there you are. All right, so we'll go make the helmet now. Now, I don't know how often I'll actually wear this armor because, well, this armor is pretty freaking sweet. Just like the armor for Matter Overdrive is pretty freaking sweet. And, oh, I'm taking damage, by the way, because I, there we go. So, like, we'll do a helmet, right? I'm taking damage because I have no blood going into my, what do you call it? Like, my life? No, that's not why I'm taking damage. Why am I taking damage right now? I'm taking damage for something. Could be have something to do with the armor. Oh, this is on. Let me turn that off. There we go. That should stop that. So then we'll add a weak blood shard there. And the divination sigil there. And bingo bango. Did anybody see where the helmet went? Where'd you go? Oh, you're way over there. There we go. And now we'll take you off. And put you on, and bam! Look how freaking sweet that helmet is. Right? Isn't that awesome? It's like, ninja, ha, I am samurai. Look at my claws. Ha. I love it. I don't know about you guys, but I love it. I think it's pretty darn sweet. And let's see. The only downside is, now, oh, when I was talking about the HUD, right? So remember when I was like, I said I had this in my hand? Now that I don't, I can still see where my life essence is. Doesn't really give me a number or anything like that, but I think it's kind of useful to have, personally. But let's see, how much essence is in here? Only about 8,000, and I don't know what level. You make, what do you make? You make this one, 15,000. So I think it'd be pretty close. If I put this in now, oh, well, wait a second. So, yeah. Armor, it's coming along. It is a waiting game. With blood magic, it's a waiting game of filling this up. And that's why what I want to do is make some sacrifice runes. As a matter of fact, that's what I'm going to do right now. Okay, yes, it's going to take a while, but I think I have some of the materials. Let me go ahead and take you off real quick. I don't know if these have to be clicked to me or not. Let me right click it real quick. Ah ha ha! Maybe that's why I was taking damage, because they weren't mine. Let me see. Here we go. Oh, I kind of shift-clicked that on now. Yep, there we go. Maybe that's why they're hurting me. I'm not 100% sure. But I can go get some of the materials, because I want to make some of these sacrifice runes, because it'll increase the amount of blood that I get per, like, hurt that my Well of Suffering is doing. And I remember it's just gold and a couple of those, a couple of these right here. Let me see. Oh, yeah, it's right here. Sacrifice rune. Stone, two of those, two gold. So let me grab some gold real quick. Let's see. One, two, three, four. I can make like two of them real quick. And I have stone on me. And then I've got some of those things over there. So, yeah, so we can make a couple of those. And what I might do, I might break right here because, like I said, it's a waiting game. Making all these like sigils and stuff like that, it is a waiting game. And so it's, you know, you never know how worthwhile it really is to film some of this stuff. But I do want to do, let's see. Okay, you're there now. Cool. So we'll go ahead and put you, oh, you're already in my, we'll get that one. And then now we should be able to make the haste one because I've got the sugar, I've got the cookies, I've got the obsidian. So it should add haste. Now, I'm already at 140% because of my robot armor. So I'm wondering if I get haste added on, exactly how fast I'm going to be. I have a feeling it's going to be pretty insanely fast. I don't know. But, no. Did I just waste a lot of blood right there? Did I just waste a lot of blood by accidentally clicking on that? I have a feeling I did. It's going to take a while. So yeah, so we'll get this next one done, and then, man, I thought I had more of these slates around here. Come on. Please don't run out. Please don't run out. Ah! Okay, I'm going to go check for some more slates. So what I'm going to do, I am going to do that. Okay, I'm going to pause. I'm going to get everything together to make the last two pieces of armor, which are going to be the whirlwind and the haste, and then I'm going to put in some sacrifice blocks. Actually, I'm going to do that first. And, oh, and I can craft up one of those right now, right? Do I have any more slates in here? No, I don't. No more slates? Okay, let's make one real quick so we can just see what the difference is, like what the difference one makes. Sorry, very dry throat right now. It's starting to warm up in Southern California. It was like 85 degrees all day long, and it tends to get a little warm like that. Yeah. All right. I know that says it has a durability with house, but I don't ever remember seeing a durability. Like, I never remember seeing it go down. I'm just reading. Okay, cool. So we've got enough to make this now. So if I remember, it was this and this, right? This and this. This guy here, and then stones. Yes, and that'll give us a sacrifice rune. Now, I don't know how big of a difference it's going to make right now. Let's see every click how much blood we're getting on average. About 100, 120, yeah, a little over 100, 120 per every time they're taking damage. Like, you can hear them take their damage. So if I take this guy out, oh, shoot. Forgot that I will fall in there. Okay, come on. Okay, so my titanium armor is obviously better because I never take damage with my titanium armor on. I totally forgot I would fall in there. Let me grab some torches so I can light that place up so nothing spawns and I can get in and get my stuff. That was so not on purpose. Oh my goodness. Like, what was I thinking? I don't think I was really thinking right there. Grab a whole bunch of torches. Oh, and light that place up. My goodness, I just fell right in there. Like, oh, let me go grab this block. My armor's not set up to protect me like that quite yet. There are more mods that I can put on it, but they're not on it yet. And I was not ready to take on all that. Okay. So, oh, that hole's still there. And so now I've got sun falling through. All right. That should stop those spawners. And I know the fire is enough to stop them from spawning too, so that's good. Oh! Knocked him into the fire. That's awesome. Burn, you little punk. Burn! Burn! Okay, cool. Hey, now I have no armor on. No, can't do that. Okay, what's going on? You guys should not be spawning right now. I've done this a lot of times. I have made a lot of mistakes in here. Hey, stop burning. I gotta plug that hole really quick. So let's get my stuff back. There we go. Let's go ahead and put my titanium armor on for right now, because until the blood armor set's complete, I don't think it's really going to help me out all that much. And let's get back into bat mode. And let's go plug this hole so my stuff doesn't burn anymore. All right, so sacrifice rune, bingo bango. All right. And now let's go see how much... I don't know if it's an increase or not. I know it's an increase. I just don't know how much. And let me turn that waypoint off. Remove that. There we go. Let's get all this junk up. You know, I actually haven't been in here. And like, when we did this, right, it works really, really well. But this chest just fills up with so much garbage. But a lot of ender pearls, which is cool. I think that's really cool. Lots of arrows, if I ever need arrows. Lots of rotten flesh. I can make a lot of leather with that. And some gunpowder, which is cool for Flams mod. So I'm getting a lot... Oh, android legs. Both ranged. Cool. I'm getting a lot of stuff, but I just can't claim it all because there's just too much. There's way too much. So let's go ahead and take these torches down now. And we can get this bad boy started back up because I need the blood. And... Hey, you're annoying. Stop it. And that torch right there. Okay. Oh, no. You all leave me alone. Door right there. Let's go. Okay. Shot me through the door. Really? All right. So now we're back to this, And let's see how much blood it's getting now with just a little bit of addition of one rune. It's actually a lot less. Why is it only doing 50 now? Maybe there were just more mobs in there. That could have been it. I don't know. It's gonna fail. But we're gonna make more of these. You walked in the wrong place. All right, so yeah, that's what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and cut here because I want to get this done. I've got about 5 minutes left or so, and I'm gonna go ahead and get some more sacrifice runes in here so we can try to speed up this process. And then I'm also gonna get the last two slates done so we can do our last two pieces of the armor. So I will be right back. All right, guys, so we are back, and I just wanted to show you. I did actually a lot more than what I said I was gonna do. I didn't just do the sacrifice runes. I was having such a long time waiting on this thing to fill up. Oh, it's 40,000 now, cool. And you can see the jumps it's making in between. It's doing two, three, over 300 per ouch that you hear down there. And so I added some speed runes in to speed up the process because we saw how long it took before. But watch this now. With the addition of a couple speed runes, not too bad at all. I mean, it soaks up the blood really, really quick. And sometime today, there it goes. So I did that because, oh my gosh, it was taking forever. Like, absolutely forever. But I've got all the speed runes in, I've got all these sacrifice runes in, and now the altar is just running a lot more efficiently. And so now I can make my, oh, it's a robot. It's like, what's making so much noise? So we can make these last couple ones here. If I remember correctly, it was sugar, 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 cookie, cookie, and the orb. Yes, so there's the haste. And then the other ones I wanted were the whirlwind and did I forget to, oops. I think I might have forgotten to grab the ghast here and the feathers. Which is okay. But oh my goodness, this took forever. Absolutely took forever. Did I forget to grab, oh, where are my ghast here's at? It never called him? I called him, right? Because I went one, two, three. And then my feathers. I got one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Apparently I didn't call for him though. Interesting. All right, so which one was it? Oh, not slates, sigils. I need to make the whirlwind, which means I need to make the air sigil first. Oh, I just need one of those regular slates there, and then which one do I need? And then the other demonic, which I have. Okay, so I just have to go make those, and I can make those over there. And then we'll have our full complete set of armor. And now this armor, it can become pretty freaking badass because there's other stuff you can do. There's like potions and stuff you can make for you. I think it's called like hardened soul, if I remember correctly, which is freaking awesome. Because you can make yourself completely immune to damage, which means you can take on the baddest mamma jamma you want. And oh, look how fast that is now. Oh wait, I gotta do the second level too. Look how fast that is. Oh, those speed runes. I've been missing them, man. I've been missing them. Wait, do I need another one? No, I don't think I need another one, do I? No. I need the air, which is like that. Okay, there. There, there, and the feathers like that. That gives us the air sigil. By the way, if you don't know what the air, let's what let me show you the air sigil real quick. When I'm not flying, you just put this in your right hand and you click, and it kind of heaves you. But I mean, you can go fast. You just got to be careful because you will take fall damage. But as long as you're clicking into the ground, like if you're forcing yourself into it, you won't take any fall damage. That sigil is freaking awesome. I'm sorry, but it's awesome. So anyway, so now I need you, the demonic slate. Yeah, you. It was two ghast tears and four feathers, like that. Yes. Okay. Cool. So now we've got that one. And oh, I need some more blood shards. I got to go down there with my swordy sword and get a couple more blood shards. We've got the haste. Hey, give me that back. Let me get my swordy sword here while I can do this. Oh, it's turned on. Why are you turned on? You shouldn't be turned on. And let's see if we can get ourselves some. This is kind of crazy to do, but. And just let a couple of you out at a time. And did I get any in the process? Nope. Okay. I can't even like really get in the door to get stuff. Oh, there's a blood shard right there. Okay. All right, let's pick some of this junk up while we're going around. Let me just try to get a couple extra blood shards here. Because you use a lot of them, and so might as well get as many as I can. Ha ha ha. Hey, leave me alone. Leave me alone. I think I got enough for right now. So we can make this last piece of armor because this is taking too long. And the episode is stretching way longer than I wanted it to again. I am trying so hard to keep them at like 25 minutes, but no longer than 30. And I tend to stretch them out. So let me turn you off. Put you in the chest. You're turned off, right? No, of course not. I never remember to turn you off. Okay, so I'm going to need you. The forge is up there floating already. And I need the blood shards. And those two. Cool. We can do these last two pieces of armor. Hey, cool. Guys will drop that for me. All right, so we've got the forge here. If I remember correctly, it has to be on the bottom for the boots. If not, let's see. Put you in there. Yep. And haste goes in there. And bingo, bango, got the boots. And then last one is the leggings. So you there. I think it's in the crotchal region. Like that, like that, like that, like that, and like that. And shard go there, whirlwind go there, and yes! Anybody see where those went? They're there. That is the funny thing is it's kind of dramatic the way it does it, but so there's that, there's that, there's the chest plate, there's the helmet, and I forgot to bond these to myself again. I need skulls. So let me go ahead and connect these to myself. Bingo, bango, bingo, bango. They're on and bound to me. So check it out. I have whirlwind, boost, and haste. Look how fast I am. It's insane. I'm not even sprinting. Now I'm sprinting. And I can give myself a jump boost. Actually, I think this one does give me a jump boost as it is. Can I jump over this hedge? Yes, I can. So yeah, I got a jump boost. I've got sprint boost. Oh, it's so awesome, this armor. And it just looks so cool. That's the biggest thing to me, how cool this freaking armor looks. I mean, yeah, it's all good and well that it's really useful, but it looks so spiffy. Oh my God, look at that armor. It's freaking awesome looking and just bouncing all over the place. And oh, it's so fast and awesome gun in my hand. Oh, dude, I am like ninja extraordinaire right now. Apparently, I don't take fall damage. Oh, but let's go find a skeleton real quick. And let me show you the funnest part about this armor. Is that whirlwind that I was talking about. The skeletons can't do anything about it. So let me get into bat mode real quick. And show you while the skeletons shoot at me that they cannot hit me. Skeletons cannot hit me. Projectiles cannot hit me. So that skeleton can easily see me, right? And he can keep heaving arrows at me all he wants. But he cannot hit me. The arrows go all over the place. They go back at him. They do all sorts of crazy stuff. But they can't hit me. Now, not that I was worried about taking damage anyways. But the fact that they can't even hit me now means that I'm not annoyed by them. So that's awesome. So I think I'll go ahead and wrap this one up here. Oh, oh, oh. But it's not as strong as the Tritanium armor. I got to keep remembering that. Let me give myself a clear path out of here. Actually, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and put the Tritanium armor just to get out of here. And then we'll call this one a day. And there we go. Tritanium armor is freaking pretty buff stuff, man. Oh, no. I love the blood armor, and there's more that we can do with it that will be coming in the future. But for the time being, it's still pretty freaking sweet. Anyways, so let me grab my orb. Oh, it's already in my hotbar. Put you in there, start sucking that up, start filling up my system. We've got more stuff we want to do with blood armor, but I think we might take a break from it, at least for the next episode, because there's some other fun stuff I want to do, and I'm going to fix up where this freaking stupid creeper blew up. But guys, I hope you guys are enjoying. I love playing this game. I love some of the mods and, like, you know, checking them out. And wow, I'm just not as fast as I was, but it's okay. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed. This blood armor, man. I want to put it back on now that I'm not in there. Because it's still pretty strong armor all on itself. And yeah, I don't think it has the durability, because I swear I just got beat up in there and I didn't take any damage. So yeah, until next time, guys, I am Slider Havoc. If you guys enjoyed, leave comments, likes, you know, add a little subscription in there if you want to. It's cool. But I hope you guys enjoyed, and we will be back. And I'm thinking in the next episode we might take on a little Abyssal Craft, because we have a new member who just joined the server, and he'll probably be in my next episode. And with that being said, he was looking for a place, and I was kind of flying around with him trying to find a location for him. And in the process, I found a thing called the Darklands, which I think I'd already seen before, but I don't remember because it was a really long time ago. And yeah, that's what we're going to do. Anyway, so guys, I'm out of here. Have a good one. Peace.